Okay, just to review, after we did the process map, all of our input variables and our CTQs were carried forward to the cause and effect matrix. And we used the cause and effect matrix to peel off the less important variables, or the things that were likely to be less important, so we could direct our attention to the important few. Now in the FMEA, we will carry forward the top items, and in this column we'll have a list of all of the items that were carried forward, and basically we'll have one sheet for each of the variables that were shown here. And not surprisingly, in our bread baking example, cook's skill turned out to be one of the more important variables. Now, over here, there's a hidden little feature. You see, I've filled in some data here for you to look at, but if I move my mouse right here in the margin, I'm able to drag the box boundaries, okay, and I can make them the size they need to be to contain what information I have to have them contain. So you can see there that I've got that one, and here I'll stretch that one out a little. Whoops, not quite enough. Try again. There we go. And one more. Come on. Get hold there. This video capture software just slows my computer down terribly. Makes it hard to live with. Okay. I have filled in for some of these items. I've filled in some typical possible things that might be added to the FMEA, just for an example. And up here we have our anchor points. Now, this is a default set of anchor points. Let me pull that onto the screen so you can see all of it. These are the scores, 1 through 10, that we give according to these anchor points. The severity here is the effect, or the severity of the effect that this would have on a customer if it happens and if it escapes to the customer. So a 1 would be no effect, and a 2 would be very minor and the customer probably wouldn't even notice. Now up here at the 10, if you're in the computer business, maybe the worst thing that can happen is that there's a sudden and catastrophic loss of data. If you're building aircraft, then the worst thing that can happen is that somebody loses their life in a crash. Occurrence is how often this thing happens based on real life experience, not on what we suppose. So here are some guidelines, okay? And detectability is how likely are we to catch this if it does happen and be able to prevent it from going out to a customer. So one would be that the current controls are almost certain to detect it. And a 10 is, we haven't got a clue. If this happens, it's going out, all right? Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is check the anchor points and make sure that they're suitable, and then we'll dive in and do the material here.